since the last time we saw this battle on land, and you've got a big smile on your face.
Yeah, it's been a long time coming. We'll finally have our answer for who is the top team, Optic Gaming or FaZe Clan. Coming off break, we're on board with Scumpy.
Let's get it. Scump will begin to push right towards middle map. He's got the weapon that in hardpoint this weekend seems to be the weapon that works for him. That OSA, such a high rate of fire, probably most similar to a submachine gun in the current meta. Off the break, it is Optic Gaming with early hardpoint control as they are completely outslaying their opponents.
Yeah, you know, these guys are going to be fresh. They just finished playing on this exact same map, and they are continuing their dominance on it. Formals, he's just been hanging inside the hill the entire time. He's not expected necessarily to do the OJ work, but he has done just that. OG with that early 21-0 lead.
They actually did have the spawns for this new hardpoint, but nice job to FaZe. Get four dead for the second. They're going to have to push through towards this barn side. Chance, how do you want to see him retake this? Should they just flood right through this underpass area, go towards Lemon right now? It seems like Optic Gaming actually want to bring the pressure to them, and OG wipe FaZe off the map.
And more importantly, they're able to keep the spawns as well. So yeah, they get that clean four down. FaZe is going to spawn even farther back. So the initial time definitely going to go towards that green side. Of course, FaZe, though, you see they're all flooding down Lemon side with the exception of one. I think that, of course, well, it's going to be Zuma on the flank. No surprise there. Still, though, FaZe, all that pressure coming in from the side, and all three players going to pick a kill up. Karma not going to be able to do anything. Zuma gets that cleanup kill. A perfect break from FaZe Gaming.
This is what you wanted to see, man. They get a clean break. These two teams so evenly matched on the retake. Now Clayster expecting the pressure to come in. One grenade misses. Shots, though, just over the shoulder of the first player who charged on in. Zuma can't clean up the backside, and now Attach pushing in from the side barn door. His teammate does get one. Second challenge comes into play, just playing his life for the second. 39-36, the score at the moment. It's about to be a tied game as we begin the rotation towards this third hardpoint.
And really, kills have been traded back and forth pretty effectively on both sides. It's just FaZe for the majority that had the better response. Of course, though, OG trying to get that scrap time. There is that final gunfight. Forward Attach is going to come out on top. Ooh. Meanwhile, though, the rotation is over. Karma's the one that has to get down these lockdown lanes. He's only able to pick up one. Scump, though, is going to be there for the trade. So again, it is going to be Optic Gaming coming out on top of that rotation battle.
Enable trying to play this close corner with the OSA. Not going to work there as Karma makes him pay for some missed shots early on. Both teams so evenly matched at the moment. Hardpoint contested for a brief second as three lineup for Scump. Now 7-6. And when he is on point, Optic Gaming are a completely different team. Scump wipes out all of FaZe, and now the crowd's getting behind him here. You gotta love it, Chance. You've got all of Old Men of Optic in the venue. You got Rain, Apex watching online. Their boys are playing as they've now moved to their new house in LA. So much on the line. Everyone happy for this battle to be back on the main stage.
An incredibly close game so far. That's gonna be three down in favor of FaZe. Make it four. Formal is gonna fall as well. And you see a split spawn actually coming in from Optic. Clayster is able to block it. So you see Crimsix all the way across the map. Gonna be coming up behind some players, but again, Optic Gaming, with that early rotation, they do have that early control. However, FaZe has been very good so far at breaking these setups.
Yeah, it's Clayster who's going to be the first one here for FaZe Clan, just trying to play this off angle, catch Optic Gaming off guard. They're trying to both challenge him at the same time, but look at how much attention he's drawing over here, Chance. Optic Gaming sending three players to try to cut him down. Clayster gets the help of Enable and Attach, and it's another clean break for FaZe. They're still up by 10. Enable now 12-8. He's on a three streak. The guy is stepping up when his team needs him to.
Yeah, and right there, you saw Clayster was timing his aggression perfectly. Another. Picks up a kill, doesn't push for anything, waits for his team to help him out. And that's a clean four down. Optic Gaming just sprinting into those gunfights, and you see how far up the map FaZe is already trying to push the hold back OG. Still, though, they are going to break through, if not just for the moment. And it actually looks like Attach is going to give up this scrap time just for a moment, or he can challenge, but he's going to be running into quite a few players, and he is going to get his life taken.
If you are just tuning in for the first time this weekend, right before this event, patch goes out, an update to Throwback Hardpoint comes in. The Lime Hardpoint removed. We will now reset at middle map. At the end of the first rotation, we've got ourselves a 10-second game as Attach gets two, rewinds, and tries to challenge the third. He gets the help of Clayster there to clean him on up, Chance. Biggest takeaway for you from this first rotation as we've got quite the close game.
Well, similar to what we saw when OG was playing E6 on the point, they're doing everything right for the rotations, but they just can't hold any of their setups. They're just not winning the gunfights when they need to most. Of course, though, with those rotations, they're getting the early time, so it's still a very tight game, but you win that battle, gotta make sure to pick up the kills. Meanwhile, Attach is doing just that, able to pick up two, getting himself inside the hardpoint.
It's what you love to watch, man. Eight of the most individually talented players in the game in just one lobby. So even so far as Skump does get the better of Attach there, immediately traded on out, though, by FaZe as they look to get the scrap time. The silver lining for Optic Gaming fans, though, they already have control of this back market area. They have players inside Barn, but this is what you're talking about, Chance. These are the gunfights that OG have to win. And as we talk about it, they go three dead. The fourth player's been spotted. It's Skump all by himself trying to make a miraculous play. It won't work out. Optic Gaming spawn out yet again.
Well, we saw last time FaZe was able to send three players through this lemon flank, and right now all four Optic Gaming members are actually going to be doing that. So, going to see what they can pull off. Karma's able to win one god fight back, but then you just see FaZe is able to slay them all out. Crimsix was the last alive, and Attach is there, gets the call out from the teammate, and cleans up the kill. Again, Optic Gaming, they are just trying to flood, and that only is going to work when you're winning all of your gunfights, and they are struggling for the moment.
You think back to when these teams battled it out so often in Advanced Warfare, it was Zuma and Attach, the duo, who made it possible for FaZe to challenge Optic Gaming so many times. Right now, they're combined for a positive 9 scoreline in the slaying department. FaZe with their largest lead of the game, now closing in on a full minute as Optic Gaming. All four players currently hovering around, even slightly negative. They need someone to light the fire. Chance, who do you think it's going to be?
Well, Karma, he was the guy that had the hot hand against E6 for quite some time. Struggling to pick up that kill. Facer's able to take that one down, and that is an instant break. Now 60 points separate these two teams. That is a full hill's worth of time. And again, FaZe still in control of this match.
And Zuma and Attach are still staying hot. You can hear the crowd now getting behind FaZe. Optic Gaming fans are quiet in the venue. They know their team cannot hold a hard point for the life of them right now as Enable gets turned on by Skump. He returns the favor. It's another three-piece at this underpass hard point. OG, they look to get the scrap time. If they get this chance, they'll be down by about 30 seconds. FaZe, though, they have their eyes set at this baseball hard point. They have the back bathroom spawns, control of bowling as well. They want to try to shut the door on this next hill, Chance.
Yeah, and last time they had this baseball field hill, it took about three pushes before Optic Gaming was able to break through, and they were doing that from the blue side of things. Now, of course, they're going to be pushing for bowling. Still, though, FaZe only has two players inside the hill. However, Enable's going to be able to pick up one. The camo's causing all sorts of problems. However, Crimsix is going to get traded out, so the camo, not all too useful. However, you see from the blue spawns, Optic Gaming is able to come and retake control of this hill.
Camo used by both teams right there. Clayster still has his overdrive ability, but Optic Gaming got the break they need. But the question that has remained this entire map, how long can they hold for? Karma with one, nearly gets the second. Not gonna happen there. Azuma is pinching in from this baseball side. It does appear FaZe get another break. It's the same thing happening over and over. Optic, maybe they get a break, but they don't hold a chance for more than 10, 15 seconds.
Well, both teams right there kind of struggled with blocking spawns. So they basically had a natural spawn to where they would be instantly pinching on the hill, both Optic and Gaming. Optic Gaming and FaZe, we saw the same thing. Either way, though, FaZe, they are going to get those final couple seconds of scrap time. And again, they have a decent-sized lead. However, Optic Gaming trying to do everything they can to make sure they get the rotation.
FaZe currently outslaying by 13 kills, Chance. When Optic Gaming have looked best in hardpoint, it's because they're commanding the map. Right now, that is not the case. They need to change that up. Zuma looking to continue to carry this momentum. A two-piece for him there. Good play. Back on down. Save this reactive armor for a more important engagement. He wins the one-on-one as well. He cannot be stopped. 197 to 147, FaZe in full control.
And if he's able to pick up another kill or two, he can use the reactive just to get streaks, not even just to break a hard point. Still 350 away, has another gunfight inside. Going to elect to push a little bit farther in, try to pick up more players. But again, this is the middle hard point, and FaZe is locked down nearly all of the time. Just 250 away from the Chinga Rocket. Has a gunfight in front, doesn't pop the armor, and he is going to fall still, though, FaZe, with a very nice lead.
I think that's a sign of a great player right there, though. Don't waste that reactive armor. Use it for a more important scenario. Clayster will actually use his overdrive to get in towards this Granny's house. He'll stay alive for the moment. FaZe now within 41 seconds of winning this game. It's a full 1 minute lead still, as Optic Gaming's opportunities to come back in this game are dwindling. FaZe are still doing every single thing right. Optic now pushing from field as they're getting desperate to get to this hard point.
Well, they do have the pinch coming out on the hill, but again, they're not winning any of their gunfights. Scump is the closest one. You see Crimsix is working on the pinch. Still base plan, just 25 points away from ending this game. Optic Gaming, they need to get inside and at the very least contest, and that is exactly what's going to happen. But no, Attach is able to pick up two inside the hill. He just went on a five streak, all important kills.
You saw right there, Zuma did pop that reactive armor to try to turn around and take down Crimsix. Skump doing everything he can so far this game inside the objective. He's still staying alive, pops a reactive armor of his own. There's two, maybe the third as well. The king has come to life as Skump wipes out three. He gets the scrap time, and now he's earning streaks of his own. Can this be the catalyst Optic Gaming need to mount the incredible comeback here in game number one? Folks, if you're just tuning in, this is the CWL Vegas Open. For the first time in 14 months, we see FaZe Clan battle against Optic Gaming on the main stage. Right now, it's all FaZe, but Skump is looking to take matters into his own hands as he's fully streaked out.
Yeah, he's going to have to use those, probably for the baseball field hill. Of course, though, FaZe 12 points away from winning. It is going to be very...
Uh-oh.
Attach has streaks of his own, by the way. Only able to pick up one in OG, still able to retain control of this hill. But again, these are the gunfights that matters most. Karma's able to pick up one. That second player back close is going for the challenge as well. Attach is going to win that one. And now FaZe is inside. 10 seconds left, and the game is over.
Optic, instead of being able to rotate, they have to push this hill. Zuma now within five. Skump calls in the streaks. This might actually hurt his teammates from getting in. No, I do believe they get a body for a second. It's Clayster near this hard point. 247. Is anybody going to make it for Optic Gaming? It doesn't appear so. One player in. It is Skump that keeps him alive for just a brief moment. Oh my goodness, Chance. The stage is set. Optic need the best hold they have had in Infinite Warfare if they want to win this game. 248 to 205. It's absolutely possible, but they need the COD gods on their side.
Well, FaZe is taking their time to set up, but Skump is going to be able to call out all those players. FaZe, though, wins the first gunfight. Skump, with his streaks, able to pick up one. One player from FaZe has been able to sneak around back.
That's
a gunfight go in favor of Optic Gaming. 25 points away, and they will make the comeback.
Streaks being used perfectly by Skump. The first gun fight won again by the green wall. Skump turns around. He's got help from Crimsix and crew. Is this going to happen, Chance? 248 to 235. FaZe have one final push. Entry kill by Enable. Karma can't answer back. Zuma and crew storming on in. FaZe have done it. 250 to 238. And oh my god, this series does